The Day the World Ended at the Little Bighorn. Preface. Sticks and Stones. The story goes that an Italian explorer landed on an island in the Caribbean and thought he had found India, and called the dark-skinned people he saw Los Indios. Whatever the details or the veracity of the story, the consequence is that all the native peoples of North America, Central America, and South America are known to most of the world as Indians.
Throw in political correctness, and there continues to be confusion over what to call whom and at what time.
There are, of course, several less complimentary names that were coined and are still around, but the most persistent generic labels, which we all seem to slap on one another, is Indian, American Indian, and Native American. Labels used less frequently, by the way, by those of us who are shoved into them. We prefer to be identified by our specific tribes or nations. Of those, there are nearly 500 ethnically identifiable in the United States. However, in the interest of avoiding confusion within the pages of this work, I have chosen to use the word Indian mostly in those instances when there is a necessary reference to more than a specific tribe or native nation. I cannot help myself. Perhaps it's the English-speaking portion of my brain. And there are instances when I will use the word native for the same reason. I will avoid using the labels American Indian or Native American, except in those cases where they are part of historical documents or statements. Native American seems to be the most popular label these days. However, as several people have pointed out to me over the years, anyone born of American parents within the borders of the United States of America or its territories is a Native American. I quite agree. Furthermore, within the context of historical time frames, much of the content of this work focuses on the Lakota people before we were granted citizenship by the United States Congress in 1924. Therefore, it seems silly to refer to the Lakota or any other Native group as Native American before they were Americans. There are no references herein to the people of India, who are, of course, the real Indians. My apologies to them for being dragged into this confusion over labels. But then, neither they or anyone from North, South, or Central America started this confusion. We are simply forced to live with it, and sometimes answer for it. Introduction. Where are you from? We all have heard that question more than we probably realize. More often than not, we respond with the name of the place we reside or where we were born or raised. That is, of course, the most obvious and seemingly logical answer. Yet there is one place where we are all from, no matter our race or ethnicity or social status. We are all from the past. Who and what we are is shaped and influenced not only by the blood of our parents, grandparents, and ancestors, but also by their values, traditions, customs, and attitudes, and by the events they witnessed and experienced. How we view the world today, as well as our individual, racial, and social circumstances, depends on what happened to our ancestors, on what they did or did not do, on what they suffered or perpetrated. Therefore, in order to understand ourselves, we must endeavor to understand who and what our ancestors were. We must understand our past. Like many people, and perhaps more than some, I, as a Lakota, struggle to answer one of many questions. Why? Why did our history, especially in the past 200 years, happen the way it did? The answers obviously lie in the past and in the people who were part of it and know of it. There are many photographs of Lakota people from the latter part of the 19th century. Whether or not we are directly descended from anyone in those photographs, we should realize they were more than individuals isolated in a moment. They had substance to them that the photographs can only hint at. They had experiences, values, ideas, character, and much more. And some of what and who they were outlived them, because someone remembered something they said and did. And that memory can be just as powerful as a photograph, because part of that person was passed on and is passed on each time a story is told. Interestingly, one of my favorite stories is about a non-Lakota ancestor. At least by blood, he was not Lakota. My paternal grandfather's father was a Frenchman. His name was Joseph. He married a young Oglala Lakota woman, my great-grandmother Elizabeth. They had a home and made a life for themselves on the Pine Ridge Reservation. My great-grandfather worked as an interpreter for the Indian Bureau. He could speak French, English, Lakota, and perhaps a smattering of Cheyenne. As a younger man, he had been a horse trader. He was also a teacher and later became an ordained Episcopalian deacon. He was sitting with several old Lakota friends one day near the issue station at Pine Ridge Agency shortly after 1900. The conversation was about horses, so he told them a story of a good, fast horse he owned as a young man. One day he happened to find an old, part log, part sod house hidden in a small valley in the Medicine Root district of the reservation. Curious, he dismounted from his horse and went inside to have a look. The house was empty and obviously abandoned. As he emerged from it, he saw three riders approaching, three young Lakota men he did not recognize. They saw a white man alone in a remote part of the reservation and loped down the hill toward him. My great-grandfather quickly mounted his horse, not sure what the men would do if they caught him. He put his horse into a fast gallop and soon outdistanced the three pursuers, who gave up the chase, realizing they had no chance to catch him. His horse was too fast for them. When my great-grandfather finished his story, a man sitting nearby stood up and approached. He had been listening with great interest. "What he says is true," the man told everyone in the group. "I was one of those three riders, and I remember that horse." Stories do have a way of connecting us. We may not have photographs of all of our ancestors.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.